lightning. I will live in the Long Island. Oh, you know it's so much fun. I'm living on the island. I'm just basking in the sun.
Hey, Anthony, give me a vodka. Is that your Camaro? It's gorgeous.
You know, I went to high school with Billy Joel.
I go to Hamptons on Friday night. I party hardy till sunshine bright. Then I'm sitting in traffic on Sunday night. I'm living on an island. Yeah, living on Long Island. Oh, you know it's so much fun. I'm living on the island. I'm not hurting anyone. Let's live.
Hey there, islanders. If you're going out to the beach, you better get an early start. Traffic is miserable.
Well, I'm coming of age, you know, bad cage. Trying to get down in Levittown. Dancing in the dark in Floral Park. I think I'll stay in Oyster Bay because I'm living.
Ciao! Welcome to the Gagutsa Show! Happy Tuesday, all of my friends! I'm Alfredo Gagutz, I love you! We got a bigger show for you tonight! Tonight our guests are Ellen Acaris, a nice Greek goddess girl, and my paisana Joey Petroni! Now, without further ado, I'm gonna kill you not! Is your host for the show, Nicola LaMonaco and Jeannie Powers! Andiamo!
Thanks, Benny Gagutz, Alfredo Gagutz, whatever your name is tonight.
I don't even know what to say.
Oh, you're so funny.
Hi.
Hey, Jeannie.
Hey, Nicole.
What's happening? I feel like a real talk show host because now I have a mug.
Yeah, I don't have a mug. I want a mug. Crazy cat lady. You are a crazy cat
lady. Do
you want
a sip of my coffee?
No.
Oh, it's very warm and toasty. Okay. I have cooties anyway.
I'm recovering from my surgery. I had surgery on Friday. But I'm making a miraculous
recovery. How do you
feel? I'm tired.
I got a brain.
A lot. It's draining.
It is.
They take a lot out of your body, literally.
They give you a lot of drugs.
Well, that could be beneficial, but also dangerous.
It was beneficial that day.
Not now.
They helped me that day. And then the next day I woke up and I felt perfectly fine. I went shopping. I went to the Emporium.
Retail therapy is the best therapy.
Yes. And then I shot. I photograph. I always say that I shoot them. I shouldn't say that I shoot them.
I know. I think it's so funny, though, that I shot them.
Because they're rappers.
I'm going to bring this mug.
I went and shot French Montana. Pew, pew, pew.
Oh, my God. You're going to get, like, threats now. Like,
no, they love me.
They probably
this squad, they love me.
They do?
Yeah.
You said he was difficult, though, because he was like...
Well, shooting French Montana, he just, like, puts his arm up, and he just kind of swings his head and then lifts it, and then he has this, like, momentum where he goes like this, and he's like, yeah, yeah, and then he puts his head...
that pendulum move.
Yeah, so it's like I'm waiting for him to lift his head up so I can take pictures of him, which drives me crazy. And then he has his squad up on the stage with him, these big, huge guys that are getting in my way.
Like
why do you have to be up there with him? Get out of my way. You're not French Montana. You're not the one making millions. Get off the stage.
French Montana. What a name.
Yeah. I don't get it. Yeah, I don't get it either.
But I like it.
So I was up there. I shot French Montana, and I was actually drained, and I didn't stay for the whole
thing. Yeah, well, you got surgery the day before.
The day before.
And then you went and you had to walk through that crowd of people. And
It wasn't as bad as 50 Cent.
Yeah.
When you and I were both there. It wasn't that bad. And then the next day, I slept the entire day. I didn't get out of bed until we had to go be on Pizza Talk.
Yeah, which was that we were on Pizza Talk, which you could watch at therealradioshow.com.
I don't think it's posted yet, though.
It's not yet, but eventually it will be. And Jeannie and myself were on there, accompanied by Carrie Caravis.
And Rich Walker.
And Rich Walker, yes. It was a lot of fun seeing them. That was unexpected. I didn't know that they were definitely coming. We were a little weary there for a second. We're like, are they coming? They're not coming. They're coming. They're not coming. They came twice. No, I'm just kidding.
And somehow... people think that we're, oh, thank you so much.
Oh, Alfredo Gagutz, you're such a nice man. Thank you so much. Ciao for now. You got the witch woman cop.
Oh, we got a witchy cop. That son
Yay,
of a bitch.
Yay, crazy cat lady and the witch woman. How perfect for us. That's amazing. So perfect.
So when we were on that show, they were insinuating we were a couple.
Yeah, everybody thinks Jeannie and I are a couple now. This is fantastic. We should just go with it and fuck with everybody.
Yeah, just tell people
we're a thing now.
We're not a couple.
No,
Not
in case
couple.
Anybody wants to I like you know, men. Call me at any point in my life. You know, I'm not. We're not.
She likes men. I like men.
But when you approach us and we don't like you, we like each
yeah,
other.
Yeah, that's right. That's great. That's great. When I was younger and I used to go to Cherry Grove for the Miss Fire Island pageant with my parents.
Oh, yeah.
And my brother would go. And if a gay guy would look at my brother, he would grab my hand.
Oh, and pretend you...
Yeah, he was like my boyfriend. Oh. My brother would be like, hold my hand.
Is your brother gay?
No.
Oh.
No, not at all. He'd be like, the guy's looking at me.
Oh, I thought maybe he would, you know,
no,
didn't like
no,
that
he's
guy.
Actually getting married in June down in Georgia. So.
Nice.
Yeah.
Georgia. Every time I think of Georgia, I think of this show that was back on the WB, like way back when in the 90s, called Savannah. And I think
that's where he's getting married, in Savannah.
Really?
Yes.
And Tom Selleck was in it with that mustache, and it was on for like a hot minute. And
it was a good show.
You remember
I
the show?
Loved that show.
Yeah, and all the women talked like high class southerners, and they were just so proper down there. And I was like, oh my God, I want to be in Savannah and talk like those women.
Yeah, it's a beautiful area.
Yeah.
Very beautiful.
I've never been there. I always wanted to go. They have the willow trees, too, over there.
I'm going in June.
Well, if you need a date or, you know, whatever, let me know.
Well, so in entertainment news,
yeah.
We lost a great musician, Glenn Frey,
yeah.
from the Eagles.
I'm not a huge fan of the Eagles.
Oh, my God. I love the Eagles.
I don't like them.
Oh, my
I'm
God.
Sorry for his loss.
How really could you not like the song Hotel California?
Just don't like it.
That was my favorite song growing up. I had the actual record. I still have the record.
You do?
Yeah.
That's going to be worth a lot of money now.
Yeah, the record. Oh, God. He was only 67 years old.
That's sad.
He's been in the hospital since, I think, November. He had colitis. He had colitis, I think, his whole entire life.
What is colitis?
It's an inflammation of your intestines.
Oh.
So it's very painful. But he eventually died, I believe, of pneumonia and rheumatoid arthritis.
Jeez.
He suffered from that. But 67, that's nothing.
That's young. That's really
very young.
That's sad news.
It is.
I'm sorry to hear that.
How
I'm sorry
you not
for
be an
your,
Eagles
his
fan?
Loss. I don't like him.
See, we couldn't be a couple.
Yeah,
that's why we couldn't be. It would never work out because she doesn't like Hotel
Take
California. And
you're Elaine from Seinfeld. Or no, I'd be Elaine and you'd be the date where he's like, Desperado. Shh. Did you see that episode?
Yes, I've seen all of the episodes.
Yeah. Desperado comes on. I'd start talking. You'd be like, shut the fuck up. Like, okay.
That's how I am anyway. I'm always like, shut the fuck up. Just stop
talking. That's true. That's true.
Just stop.
Well, now I guess when it comes to the Eagles, it'd be like doubled. But yeah, what else is going on in entertainment news?
The Oscar nominations had come out last Thursday. And
is Leo nominated?
Leo is nominated
okay.
for The Revenant.
Okay.
They received 12 nominations, the most nominations.
I got to see this movie.
Yeah, it's very good. And also Mad Max Fury Road received 10 nominations. Straight Outta Compton received the nomination, which was one of my favorite movies from last year.
I didn't see that either.
Oh my God, such a good movie.
I'm the worst. I don't see anything.
Such a good movie. It got best original screenplay.
Okay.
Star Wars got 5 nominations, so you'd be happy to know about that, but not best picture. It got all like video editing and best sound mixing and things like that.
Okay.
But the controversy right now is hashtag Oscars so white. I don't know if you heard about that.
I didn't, but I know that Jada Pinkett Smith has a video going on right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, she wants...
Does that have something to do with it?
Yes.
I didn't watch it.
Well, it's after last year they said the same thing about the Oscars being so white and there's no nominations for African American, not enough nominations, not enough diversity for the Oscars. Jada Pinkett Smith is now saying she wants all her people, the African Americans, to boycott the Oscars.
Wait a minute. I'm ignorant to this stuff, so... Wasn't there like a big breakthrough moment last year of the Oscars?
I believe it was the year before that with Django Unchained and
no, I forget her first name. She was I don't understand what they're asking for.
They're asking for more nominations, and even the president of the Academy, who I believe is Cheryl Boone. I think she is African-American. And the members of the Academy, she's trying to get the members to be more diverse because it seems that they're filled with more.
So they're asking for more nominations, not categories then, right?
They're asking for more nominations, like Idris Elba from The Beast of No Nation. I think it was The Beast of No Nation or Beast of No Name, something like that. He didn't get nominated.
Right.
Will Smith didn't get nominated for Concussion. And... Michael B. Jordan didn't get nominated for Creed, where Sylvester Stallone did. But as Alan Rickman, who also had just passed away from Harry Potter,
right.
had said, He is quoted as saying, it's not the actor that gets the nomination, it's the role.
Right.
So if you want more nominations for diversity for African Americans, the roles have to be there for African Americans. That's my point. But where are my Asians at? Because it's not just about African Americans. There is no Hispanic. There's no Hispanic diversity there. There's no Asian roles out
there. Isn't there an entire, like, award ceremony for Latinos? Isn't there, like, the Latinos award ceremony?
I have no freaking idea.
Sure there is.
Like, but the Oscars is the biggest movie award ceremony.
Yeah, no,
and
that
that's what they're talking about. Like, and, you know, Chris Rock, he's the host. So they want him to step down, but he's not going to step down. He's calling it the white BETs right now.
Okay. All right. I don't understand racism. I just don't get it. I don't agree with it. I don't like it.
There isn't a lot of diversity in roles. There isn't.
No.
I agree with that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't watch enough movies, I guess, to know.
And it doesn't. I don't want to take away from the roles that the white people have, because they are excellent. They're excellent actors, and
right.
They deserve the nominations, as well as you can't give the nominations to everybody, but.
I'm trying to think back of, like, when there was Oscars and, like,
like Morgan Freeman, like in 2004, Morgan Freeman was nominated, Don Cheadle was nominated, and then all of a sudden it just kind of turned back. There wasn't any more roles for African Americans. But there's also not enough roles for Hispanics. There really aren't.
No.
You don't see Jackie Chan getting nominated.
No,
We don't see Jackie Chan getting nominated because what do we do? We just go around karate chopping people.
Yeah,
because we're just typecast.
Is there a film category for, like, kung fu movies or, like, martial art movements or?
No, I mean, I think, what was that movie where we were flying around?
Russia?
Hidden Dragon.
Oh, yeah.
Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon,
yeah,
which was an amazing movie.
Didn't that win awards?
Yeah, we did good. We did good for that movie.
You did us proud.
My people did well. I couldn't believe it when I was in that movie theater and I saw those Asians flying through those trees. It's like, damn.
I wish I could move like that, but they were all strung up on strings.
No, they were really flying.
You're right. They were. So pretty much the Oscars, that's a touchy subject, I guess.
It's very touchy.
I
right
hope
now.
That there are more people nominated and everybody's needs get met. And, you know,
I just, you know what?
World.
I just want to see Leo win.
Right.
A Revenant.
Everybody,
but
I think
you know
on
what
board
I think is
that.
Gonna happen?
He's not.
Lady Gaga is gonna win an Oscar before Leo does because
no.
She is nominated for best song.
She was in a movie?
No, she wrote a song.
Oh, what for what?
Heartland, I think it was. She wrote it. She's one of the writers for a song. I don't even know which one because
Jeez.
I never heard of it.
Imagine that.
Yeah. The bear should have got nominated. For best bear mauling.
Oh
the
my
bear.
Goodness.
I mean, Jennifer Lawrence was nominated.
I want to watch it. When is it?
February 20-something.
February 20-something. All right. Well, I'm
going to
tune into that and watch it so I can actually know what we're talking about on these things of current events and entertainment. Because I'm obviously so good at knowing everything that goes on in the world. I'm so oblivious. I don't know. I just, like, I want to care about you guys, but I just have so much of my own stuff going on.
I don't want to care about you people, but I don't.
It's like, oh, that's good for you.
I want to get nominated.
You will.
For my people.
For your people.
I'm actually going to take acting classes. I'm signing up.
Okay.
At the Gateway Playhouse.
Excellent.
On Mondays. You should sign up too.
Come on Mondays?
On Mondays.
How much is it? I'm in.
$325. You don't have to pay it all at once. You can pay it as you go.
I might be in. So that sounds good. Anyway, we're going to wrap it up with our little segment here. And we have guests tonight. We'll mention
Oh, that's
that.
Right. That's There's right. other people besides us
Yes,
here.
That's right. Mm. We're going to bring them on. Our first guest is going to be Joey Petroni, who we're going to show you a clip by him right after this. And we're also going to be joined by Ellen Cavis. I want to say I'm saying her last name right, Cavis. So when you get the... When you get this, oh my God, leaving a voicemail right now. So when you get this call,
when you get this message, give me a call back. Beep.
That's what I was gonna say.
We'll be in the room getting busy because you know we're a couple now.
We'll be right back. You're watching the Gagoot Show on madhousetv.com.
.com.
know that. You don't even know.
You're on the ball list, so you can't even answer. I'm asking you about it. You gotta be highly skilled. You gotta be highly skilled. You understand that? Are you well versed there? Are you very smart man? Hit me with some funny shit.
My shit's twisted.
Tell me something. Tell me
what
something.
What do you have right there?
That's awesome.
Well,
that's a big.
That's nice.
You know damn well. You know damn
that's
well.
Awesome.
Damn
that's well. Awesome. That's awesome.
Sir.
That's
awesome. Sir. Hey, are you interested?
Twisted
talent.
Yes, I am.
Sure.
Sure.
I see you guys.
Twisted.
I see you guys.
Twisted.
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 That's twisted. That's talent.
You see what I'm saying? You understand me? And if you can't whip out answers like that, that man is liable to go on a commercial break, punch your fucking mouth loose. You understand me? Time is up, sir. You understand me? You're on. You're the man. You're the man. All right. Give me your name now. I'm sorry.
My name is Willie.
Willie, where you working at?
We are twisted. We are awesome. We are awesome. We are awesome. We are awesome.
Can you repeat that question again? Question again?
Galaxy Luxury Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin.
150.
We're gonna get a quote for $150.
How do I know it wasn't used ever, like, you know, for?
First of all, it's against the law to sell a used car for what else? Don't roll look at
no,
me.
No, but it looks kind of old, you know.
It is. It's been down the basement a long time.
So one of the peg holes is cracked with it.
I'm not gonna go less than $200. Seriously, I'm not gonna let it go for that.
$200.
Yeah, $200.
All right,
Joe. You and Vinny go downstairs. I sold the coffin. Get it up here, please.
Really?
Yeah, real.
What are they gonna do with it?
Coffee table.
Dead man walking.
The most unusual item you can buy.
It's from Shea Stadium?
80, of course, dude.
Wow.
So this guy walks up, he looks like some kind of reject from an 80s metal band.
Yeah, he was a cool guy.
Good guy, nice, cool New York accent, and it winds up he's a huge Met fan.
It's an awesome idea, yeah. Man, I'll tell you.
Take a seat, dude.
I would have never thought of doing something like
these
this.
These chairs, all the controls still work. You got the kickback.
Oh, yeah?
You got the cushion that goes up and down.
Oh, yeah?
Look at that.
Wow, yeah, this is awesome, man.
Sit back, watch awesome. A game.
They should put these in Shea Stadium now.
They should, yeah. Yeah.
You have a healing ability with laughter, my friend. You like to make children laugh, and you're good at it. Get yourself involved with writing possibly a show.
Say that I should keep writing. Her telling me that I should pursue it is great because now I know that I have to do this. You know, this is something I should be doing.
I don't know why. Today, more than any other day, the clock is bothering the hell out of me.
I'm trying to go with a spicy sauce. So I run to the pantry, I get a smoky chipotle sauce or something like that. It's a hot, sweet plate.
How hot is it?
I used a can of hot peppers, and I used the light green pepper over there. I'm not sure of the name of it.
You didn't have enough hot pepper in there, so you needed to put more?
But I thought it was gonna be sweet.
I'm starting to sweat. Very spicy. Only flavor I get is one extremely hot dish, that's all. I definitely see some steps back today.
And right now, friends that I had from high school calling me to be back in a band I used to be in.
But you're not in high school anymore.
We won Battle of the Bands two years in a row back then.
That's 25 years ago.
I've done comedy. I've done tile work. I've painted houses. I've installed ceiling fans.
Jack of all trades.
I do everything. And I can do everything. And I never say no when I get a phone call.
But your wife thinks that you're going to lose $2,000 a month going after this.
That's the negative side. She's looking at it on a negative angle.
I will tell you, I went back into Walmart with the coffee maker, walked up to the counter, slammed it down, and said, I want my money back. No questions asked about any receipts, money in hand, okay? Now, listen, I don't want to put women down, but I will tell you right now, my dad told me a long time ago, with all due respect, that women are all the same, just pick one, okay?
And we're back on The Gagoot Show with our first guest, Joey Petroni. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Yes. How you been? I haven't seen you in quite some time.
I've been very good, man. Everything's going really well for me.
I haven't seen you in years.
Yeah, I haven't seen you in a long time, yeah.
He saw you at the Velvet Lounge in Stony Brook.
Yes, that's right. Chris
with
Roach.
When was that? It was a few years ago.
Jimmy Britt.
Yes.
Yep. I love Jimmy Britt. Jimmy Britt, I think, wants to secretly murder me in my sleep or something, but I love Jimmy Britt.
Jimmy Britt's a great guy. He really is. He's a very smart
guy. I love his artifacts and he has in his basement.
In his basement.
I was down, so
that would be the place that he would kill me.
You've been in his basement.
I have, because I did. I was on the show Gwendolyn and Jessica Colazzo had a show.
Yeah, they had their podcast.
Yes, and I was a guest down there, and he had Bubo the Owl from the original Clash of the Titans.
Oh.
And it's one of my favorite movies.
Yeah, we wouldn't work out. I hate owls.
I got a Yoda doll.
I love Star Wars.
It's a collection. I think it's 2,873 or something like that.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a collector's item. I have to hide that in my attic because my kids are scared of it.
Really?
Yeah. I got two little girls that are scared of it.
Aww.
They won't go in the garage because they know it's up in the attic.
So we just saw your video that we just came back from. You're many faces of Joey Petroni all over TV. There was True TV, there was Divorce Court, there was, what was the other one that was there with recently the one with your wife? I've never seen that
the
one.
The TD Jake Show.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's, it's about my wife and I just getting advice. We go out and get advice, you know. The Divorce Court, I was in a coffee shop and my wife and I got into an argument and I actually threw my laptop computer and it smashed the screen. And it so happens to be that someone in the coffee shop knew somebody who could get us help. And it actually went to Divorce Court. One of the producers got wind of it, and that's how we got on Divorce Court.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I honestly didn't realize that you were on all these different things.
Most of it is just seeking advice, and then, winds up on TV. It's not like I'm searching for it or anything like that.
And there was the Food Network?
Food Network. That was because I can't cook.
Right.
My wife works full time. And she's always in the city working. I'm home with three kids and we're getting McDonald's. You know, we're getting fast food. We're eating cookies and cake, you know.
There's nothing wrong with that.
So I can't cook. Every time I tried to cook, I was burning stuff. So she knew somebody who knew somebody to get me help. And next thing you know, I'm with Bobby Flay. And,
to get me help. You got help
with
for
Bobby Flay. He's cooking with Bobby Flay.
Yeah.
So when you were cooking with Bobby Flay, which girl did he have with him backstage?
Oh, I don't even know. I wasn't paying attention.
He's a hooch.
He's a nice guy.
He's a hoochie mama.
Is he? Yeah, he's
a hoochie mama.
He's a nice guy.
He just divorced his wife.
Oh.
Did he really? Yeah.
Yes, he just divorced the girl from
Wow, yeah. He's a good cook, man, I'll tell you that. He's very impressive.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah, you know, I learned just not to think so much and just freaking cook it, make sure it's done, you know. It's better than fast food.
And the peppers, you know.
Yeah, I had hot peppers on there. I almost burned the chef.
Amberell,
yeah. So, it was tough, man. It wasn't easy because the clock was going the whole time, you know.
Yeah,
it was not
easy.
Yeah, it was under pressure. But I wasn't doing it to be in a contest. I was trying to learn how to cook.
He literally just wanted to boil some water.
There's a million other cooking classes that you could go to on Long Island. He ends up on Food
with
Network.
Bobby with Flay. Bobby Flay. Come on.
So I just wanted to learn how to cook.
It was cool. I got to tell you, it was definitely a great experience, and I learned a lot. Now I do all my own cooking, man. You know, I made hot dogs last night.
No, you know what you need to do? You need to make the hot dog, then you need to make macaroni and cheese and put the macaroni and cheese on the hot dog. It is amazing. Your
macaroni
kids...
and cheese on top of hot dogs.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
This one has, like, the recipes that'll knock your socks off a thing. She's telling me the other night, I'm talking to her on the phone, and she's like, you gotta get a waffle machine, and you put hash browns, what was it in there?
Or yeah, you put a hash browns. You put frozen hash browns in the waffle machine, and with, you could put some cheese in there, and you just close it. And you can put some bacon in there, and you just close it and let it cook.
Cinnamon buns.
Or you take some cinnamon buns right out of the package, and you put it in the waffle machine. You close it.
So good.
And it turns into a waffle.
And then you turn it a waffle. Nice. And then you take the frosting, and you spread it over it. And then you take some vanilla bean ice cream, and some whipped cream, and some caramel sauce.
I can't. I'm hungry now.
Come on,
I did that for Super Bowl.
I know, right? You're making us hungry.
So, yeah. So, anyway, now what I'm doing these days now is I just started my own. I had it, but now I started my own landscaping business. I'm opening it up again. I'm very excited. You know, I got a lot of customers calling me back from my childhood days in Love It Town. And so I'm getting full force into landscaping.
All right.
And what's good is now I know it's the winter, but I'm doing snow removals too.
That's good.
Well, that's going to be great for this weekend.
I'm looking forward.
Snowstorm Jonas comes and dumps a foot on us.
I know. I just came from Home Depot. My buddy helped me out. He opened up the back door. I got some bags of rock salt. See, I have my landscaping business has no overhead.
Okay.
Everything I do.
You do yourself?
I charge for labor. There's no overhead at all, so my prices are down.
Right.
Like the rock salt, I don't pay for it. You know, I know people at the Home Depot and at Lowe's.
I'm not really stealing.
It's bags that are ripped and stuff like that.
That they're going
to. Yeah, they put them to the side for me. I pull up and just throw them in my truck.
There you go.
And then with the landscaping, I put in the bushes and all that stuff. And I write up the contract. I never charge for the actual materials because I get all that stuff on the side of the road too, you know.
You're like a bushwhacker?
Yeah, you know, I don't charge for materials. I don't have any overhead. So it's nice. My prices are low and the customers are happy, you know.
So when so you started this now already.
The landscaping, yeah. I have 20 customers right now that are under contract with me.
Okay.
And, you know, I have a partner who's working with me, and we're going to run a commercial on probably Long Island news stations or something like
cool.
that. And, yeah, that's my new business, you know. And what's nice is not only do I do the landscaping, like this older couple that I just signed them up under a contract, I went food shopping for them. They can't get out of the house. You know, they're both in their 80s. So,
nice.
So I go out to the food store for them. I do all their food shopping, you know, and I get paid like $20. You know, it's not bad.
I guess they never heard of Peapod.
And they make me lunch.
They make you lunch.
Yeah, they make me lunch. Well, Peapod, yeah, they said that Peapod, they don't trust them. You know, they can never tell when they come in and all that stuff. And they know me, you know. They trust me.
And Peapod, they don't always have what you want.
Like yeah, Peapod, I don't know, man.
Peapod.
Yeah.
I love Peapod.
Yeah, you use Peapod.
I love it.
So.
So, with that being said, you're starting a new business. Are you still doing comedy as well?
I love doing stand-up comedy, and I do it whenever I can. I even do it when I'm landscaping.
You do?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Do it to your customers?
Before I start landscaping, when I'm getting the material off the truck and stuff, I'll do stand-up right there, man, you know?
There you go.
Yeah, it's good. It's all good. My goal is to eventually, and this is something I'm working on, is to have a landscaping truck. When you pull up to a house, right?
Right.
The landscapers come, and I was thinking of maybe hiring a juggler, some dancers, some gymnastics. So when you pull up to do the landscape, think about this, okay?
I'm listening.
And I'm mowing the lawn. There's a whole show going on. Summertime, in the summertime. Think about the summer.
I'm a gymnast.
Think about...
She's a gymnast. I'm a gymnast. I can't juggle,
Kids are home from school. Mom and dad say, tomorrow the landscapers come at 10 o'clock. Kids get up early. Can't wait till the landscapers come. We come, we do a 10-minute landscaping.
Like a circus.
A circus is going on.
Like a Cirque du Soleil.
You got balloon animals. You got a cotton candy machine. You got gymnastics. You got a magician. You got some DJ music.
You can hula hoop.
I can do backflips.
Yeah.
A show is going on their front lawn while I take care of the landscaping.
But wait a minute.
Instead of hearing weed whackers and hearing the buzzing from the weed whackers, you hear music. DJ's going, bam, you know.
I like that, but...
10 minutes in and out. Then you move on to your next property.
10 minutes.
But let me ask you a question. It's probably going to have to take place in the driveway because if they are on the front lawn, how are you going to mow it?
You're going to get hit with rocks.
We'll be doing
in
the backyard.
Face.
You guys do in the front yard. You go on the driveway. You go out by the street. Go on the sidewalk. Everybody looks out the window, and everybody looks out the window when landscapers come. Doesn't matter if they're weed whacking, blowing leaves. It's just
they hate it.
Yeah, they hate it. But now you can make the landscapers more likable.
I like
like that.
Right? Instead of hearing the buzzing of a weed.
You're already likable. You're white.
Instead of hearing the noises from a weed whacker, you're listening to the cha-cha slide with dances.
Cha-cha slide.
Okay, the kids, instead of the kids, you know.
Cha-cha slide.
Instead of the kids watching TV and playing with their iPads, they're looking out the front window or they're outside getting cotton candy, balloon animals, and all that kind of stuff. Magic show is going on in the driveway. But the best part is within 10 minutes, we pack it up and we're out of there like it never happened. Next house.
All right. Well, that's so certainly...
I'm working on that. So I'm looking for gymnastics. I'm looking for singers. I'm looking for guitar players. Any entertainer that would be interested in being in my landscaping business, it's going to be something new.
Where could they reach you at?
You can just look me up at joeypetroni.com or Joey Petroni on Facebook.
All right.
Let me know what your talent is, and we'll get you involved in my landscaping company.
Awesome. That sounds super interesting, and I cannot wait to see who does that. I don't actually have a lawn for you to mow because I live in an apartment.
Okay.
Upstairs above a nail salon, so there's literally no lawn around me, so I might as well be in Queens.
I could do your food shopping.
But if you do my food shopping,
hot dogs and macaroni and cheese.
Macaroni and cheese.
Thank you so much for joining us.
No problem, man. Thanks for having me on.
We'll have you back on a little later on in the show.
Nice being here.
We'll be right back. You're watching The Gugut Show on madhousetv.com.
Let's bring in our Bulls and Bears. Spending $4 on a cup of coffee, total discretionary spending. Ellen, what do you think this report is telling us?
I, you know why it's up? Because the government hasn't focused on coffee yet. Wait till they start to monitor your coffee.
That's it.
Then we're done. So shh.
Line Good of the century.
Well, you know, we should let people know Ellen is actually a comedian. So there you go. There's
a CPA, a Merrill Lynch worker, and a comedian.
Yeah, I know. Strange,
that's a good
but
combination.
True. I know. Look at me now. I'm talking about derivatives. Wow. I've just come full circle, everybody.
So look who's here, everybody. Ellen Karras. If you follow us on Twitter, she's Greek Chick Comic. And she really is Greek. She's a chick, and she's a comic. And you do a lot of great things, and I want to talk about that.
Oh, thank
This is a lady that goes to Memorial Sloan Kettering and puts on shows for patients there. You are an angel in spirit and in actuality. So we appreciate that.
You lead by example.
Oh my gosh, thank you. I do nothing. Yes. I'm just consuming Aaron coffee. That's all. I'm yeah. a consumer of that, those things. Tell me what you're wearing. You look adorable.
Finally, pet care? Has anyone really tried to write off their pet care?
Now, Liz, I live in a building where they love dogs. The woman upstairs from me has two Cocker Spaniels, Laverne and Shirley. And she asked me if she can deduct the vet bills, but the IRS doesn't care about your pets. They don't care that the vet ripped you off for $5,000 to take out Shirley's tonsils. They don't care.
Why?
Right, because, well, you did it correctly. You have to move for work, but there's even limitations with that because you have to move within 50 miles. From your former residence for that to be deducted. And it's only for employment. So if you fall in love on Facebook and move for that person, and by the way, that relationship's not going to work anyway.
Right.
But that's beside the point.
I'm going to tell you, I honestly knew my husband for a long time. We knew each other for over 10 years. I know, 10 years. And people always wonder, like, why do two people get married after they know each other for so long? They've been together. What's the point? I'm going to tell you. Okay. Because, and seriously, I do get very emotional. So, you know, we're Greek, you know. It's like crying is easy. Because one day you look at that person and you realize you're not going to do any better than that.
And we're back on The Gugut Show with our guest, Ellen Karras. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Nice to be here.
Yeah.
The red couch.
The red couch. It's very sexy.
Yeah,
I like it.
Like Gina's hair.
Yes,
very sexy hair.
You have great hair.
Thank you.
We were talking about you have like a man wants your hair, like to even to tug it. Isn't that nice? That's what I just said in the first 10 seconds.
Yes!
I never had hair like that, but my hair was longer, and I just cut it.
I love it. Like jagged, choppity.
Yeah.
It's okay, because I'm
perfect for you.
Thank you so much.
It's that hair, like, I just went to the beach, and I'm relaxed, and I'm cool vibe. I love it.
Is that the vibe? Because I was an accountant once in my life, so
I
I'm really trying to have some type of a vibe. And I haven't been an accountant a long time.
I do like accountant hair.
I've been a comic, and
this is like sea salt hair.
This looks like
simple. Spray it, scrunch it, and go.
You know what it was?
This is not simple.
It's not, right? Okay, good. So I'm out of that mode. Okay, good.
Yeah,
finally.
Let that go. When did you stop becoming a CPA?
Actually, I still have a license. So you only get the license taken away if you've like committed fraud, which I haven't.
Okay.
So, but it's inactive. So I have a CPA, and I went to graduate school, so I got an MBA in finance. I worked on Wall Street.
So you're smart.
I don't know, because you know the jury's still out on exactly how smart I am.
Because
I became a comic with no career. So let's you know save the smart thing. I can memorize. But 8 years ago, I took the plunge and I quit my job. And at the same time that the bottom fell out on Wall Street, which I saw.
Good timing.
I kind of knew it when, and the only reason I'm even bringing it up is because now we have all these movies coming out, like the Big Short and 99 Homes, and there's a new show on Showtime, Billions, and
Billions,
it's all about like Wall Street and bashing Wall Street and all this other kind of stuff.
I did watch
The Big Short last night. And
what'd you think?
I think it's
worthy of the nomination?
The acting was great. Yeah, and it was interesting the way that they filmed it.
Everybody in it?
Yeah, Brad Pitt and Ryan Gosling.
He's with Christian Bale.
Okay.
What I have to say that they didn't say, because they said this is a true story. So I think it was the true story of all those people and what happened. And certainly it gave you a good description of mortgage-backed securities, because it's all very technical. And unless you've studied it, I mean, who knows what this stuff is. But what they forgot to mention was, you know, all these people getting mortgages, that actually was started by the government from the 70s, Jimmy Carter, wanted, I think it was called the Community Reinvestment Act, which was signed into law by Bill Clinton, where banks were forced to give people loans even if they weren't qualified.
So sketchy.
That was like a huge piece of the true story that they forgot to mention.
Wow.
Oh. Yes. We're forced to. You know, and then of course, and then Wall Street's about making money, and you know,
see,
all those projects are considered.
I would never know it.
Yeah. So anyway, but I left around that time.
And I have a mortgage, and I don't know it.
Well, if you pay your mortgage, nothing to worry about. And yeah. then of course, you know, it's so interesting. It's like, you know, they put these laws in that, you know, causes destruction only to enact more laws to fix what they screwed up in the first place. So that's taxpayer money for you. Yeah,
wow.
Exactly. But I left, but I was doing stand-up while I was working. And I took a lot of acting classes, and I studied at night, and improv, and I studied Meisner for 2 years. I wanted to be an actress, so... working out just grand. I'm sure you've seen me in
I'm trying to get her to take an acting class. I'm starting on Monday. I'm taking an improv class.
Oh, you are?
I'm trying to get her to go with
me.
Oh, yes.
I want to. It's just, you know, I'm a comedian and I only make so much money.
Yeah, I know. $359. I just did a play last November.
You did?
Yes.
Which was fantastic.
With the sexy hair. With the hair.
Actually, it wasn't sexy at all.
It wasn't sexy at all. I had it pulled back in a bun the whole time. I was in the waiting room. I played a bound Asian woman from the 18th century. I was totally typecast. So my hair was not down and sexy at all.
Right.
And I played a psycho Asian girl. Uh-huh. And
if it pays, I'll do whatever. I'll play the Greek waitress.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I'm always typecast
as the Asian.
And I loved it. I had a great time. Great. Nicole came to see me.
You should do improv. You have fun hair. You've got this whole punk rock thing, you know, like I could never pull that off.
I was younger, I would totally. But
yeah,
I would like to try and do improv. And you took classes and whatnot. Did you find that if you took improv classes?
Yes, yeah. UCB, Upright Citizens Brigade, Amy Poehler had started that.
Did you find that it helps you better on stage with crowd work?
Absolutely. It's all about it.
Weakest.
And that's what I mean, stand up, even though you go up there and you have your set list for the most part. I mean, there are a few comics that just go out there but they've been doing it for 30 years.
Right.
I wouldn't recommend that, especially to anybody who's starting out. But I've been doing it now for almost 15 years. You know, I'll go out with something in my mind, a set list in my mind. But first of all, things are going to happen. People are going to say something. You know, something is going to hit you in the moment. You're going to ask somebody a question, whether it was you just said a joke and they reacted. So that's all improv.
Improv, of course.
It's spontaneous, in the moment.
Because that's what I find is the most challenging. I mean, obviously you've been doing, I'm sure you've hosted shows before at some point.
Yes.
And hosting is like, you want to be strong with your crowd work, and it can be challenging sometimes, especially if you don't have the necessary skills or whatever it is. Sometimes you want to be able to be that quick. And
the MC is the hardest, I think. I mean, obviously the headliner has to carry the show at the end.
Right, of course.
And also he's getting people an hour later after they've drank and ate and all that stuff. You know, we always say the feature spot is the prime spot.
It is.
But if you're doing a three-person show, but you're going out there cold, they're ice cold, people are still getting in their seats, people are still coming in, they're ordering, they're not paying attention, it really is the hardest thing. And then
you have to warm them up.
I had coached with somebody, and he taught me this, and it was just the best piece of advice. It's crowd herding. You have to make people feel like they've all come together. This way they'll laugh together, and they'll clap together, you know, it's all
That's
about
smart.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So, but it's, you know, it's a lot of shows. I mean, there are people that, like, know how many shows they've done. I have no idea. I don't know, 15 years. I don't know.
Yes, a lot of people keep track of everything, and they count. God bless them. You would think, as an accountant, I would.
I'll tell you what I have tracked, the money I have not made. That's what I've been at a running carry forward loss, okay? And it's not the capital gains kind where you can, like, take off against gains. It doesn't work that way.
Now, I just want to touch base on something. You're in the mix of writing a book.
Yes, I'm. Yes,
are
I'm trying
able to talk about
yeah,
this?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I mean, I haven't gotten very far, but I'm always writing like something new, depending on what the time is. But I'm writing something about political correctness. So that's basically, and I'm just. I think the best way I'm approaching this book is just to say what's on my mind and not filter it, which is actually, you know, it's part of being a comedian. I also have a radio show on the internet, so like this, you know, you were able to say.
What's the name of the show?
It's called Karis's Comedy Corner. It's on bboxradio.com. It's on Mondays from 3:30 to 4:30. But if you go to my website, you can get the past episodes.
What's the name of your website?
EllenKaris.com, EllenKaris.com. I like these two. They're helping me. So I'm writing a lot of things. I like also pop culture. And I think politics is fascinating, frustrating and fascinating
pop
at the
culture,
same time.
Right.
And now, especially, we're going into an election season. Although, you know, with the advent of the internet and talk radio and internet shows like these, you know, where politics has definitely become like a pop culture topic.
Right.
So
especially with Donald Trump.
Yeah. But before that, with Obama and Bill Clinton and George Bush, and you know, they all. You know, their time was ripe because now we have so many more outlets to make fun of them.
Yeah, but Donald Trump brings it to its peak.
Yes.
Yeah, he stirs the pot for everybody.
Yes. But I wanted to mention, because we talked about improv, so the school I went to was Amy Poehler School that she started, who's her and Tina Fey.
Yeah.
And I'm in the movie Sisters that just
came out. You are? Yes.
Oh,
my gosh. My daughter just went to see that.
Okay, so I don't have any lines, but I was core background. But I worked on it for 3 weeks. As a matter of fact, because you guys are Long Island based, we were at Bethpage at the old Grumman. It was a studio. It was amazing.
Oh, yeah. My mom was telling me.
Yes, Gold Coast. It's called Gold Coast Studios.
Spider-Man was filmed there.
Yes, yes. And it was not last summer. It was the summer before. And it was amazing. So I got to work with Tina Fey and Amy Poehler, Maya Rudolph, John Leguizamo, Rachel Dratch.
Oh,
my God. I just got the chills.
John Cena. It was a great experience. I was there for a month. So if you see it, I'm in a pink dress, a hot pink dress.
Okay.
And I'm dancing around. I'm actually in it a lot, in the party. There's a big party scene.
Yeah.
I'm in the party.
Oh, that's so
exciting.
It really was. It was long hours, though, I have to tell you. There are times, you know, where you get home till like 2 in the morning.
So what?
But you know what? Exactly, because I worked that 9 to 5, which is really a misnomer, right? I mean, I work many more hours than just 9 to 5. But when you work those jobs, it's like never ending. I like these movies and TV shows because it's like a project. It's like you go and then you do work intensely, but then you'll have a little time off, you know. And I mean, obviously, you're always looking for the next thing,
right?
But still, I mean, it's a different kind of schedule.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's good. So I didn't mind. I wouldn't mind
because I never sleep, so I wouldn't mind.
Yeah.
Something like that. Would have loved this. Okay. The only problem was the craft service table, you know.
I would enjoy that.
You would devour
immensely.
Craft
service. Where is it?
And you know what? I mean, people are like, oh, you should eat something healthy, because I'm like, I go to this dance studio and all the girls are really healthy and everything.
Like, yeah, we're not.
Yeah, awesome. And you know, have a piece of fruit. Have a piece of fruit. You know, because the fruit at 2 o'clock in the morning tastes just like a Kit Kat bar.
Yeah.
You know, right? Exactly. So I it's a hard. It's hard, especially like, you know, at that witching hour.
Yeah. No way would I be eating fruit at 2 a.m.
Yeah. No, me neither. Mm-mm. Yeah. You want like macaroni and cheese. You want
chips and dip.
Oreos, and it's like it is. You want Oreos? Work on a movie set.
Oreos.
Yeah.
Double stuffed.
Very long on
actually
Oreos.
Mega stuffed.
Beautiful.
Mega, yeah.
Mm-hmm. We just got the wraparound here, so. Which I'm unsure of if we're getting a commercial break or
something's
if
happening.
We're wrapping up right now.
I love
we're,
I don't know what's going on.
We're going to go to a quick commercial.
Oh, is that commercial?
And
Benny's,
we'll be right
Benny's
back.
Benny's penis size.
You're watching The Gagoot Show on manhousetv.com.
No cue cards.
I'll be right back.
This. Yeah,
this way it's cool.
Wally's been around forever.
Yeah.
He looks like a kid.
He does.
But he's been around a long
Black time. Black doesn't crack.
Oh, he not him. So we're getting the finger.
Oh, we're back!
Oh, we're back! We're back! And we're open on Betty, who has no clue what's going on.
Well, this is the Gagooch Show. Anything could happen here. We always get weird. So we're back with our guest, Joey Petroni, Ellen
Karras.
Karras, there it is. I saw a woman last night. Her name is Carrie Caravas.
Oh, I know Carrie.
And I kept saying her name earlier, and I'm like, fuck.
Yes. We're both Greek.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, there's a lot of Greek people. There's like seven of us left. And Carrie and I, John Stamos.
Seven.
Yes.
John Stamos.
Just out of rehab.
Seven of you left in New York?
That's it. We're not multiplying.
No.
No, not like Asians.
We have all of us. All of us.
Can I ask a question quick?
Sure.
You used to be an accountant, I think?
Yes, I was a CPA, yeah.
I'm just starting a landscaping business. I'm trying to do it all legit. I'm getting paid.
You should.
No, I am. I have to get insurance.
Especially since we're on camera.
Yeah. No, but I have to get insurance and I have to get waivers because, one time I cut through a sprinkler line. I got sued.
Uh-huh.
I didn't have a waiver, so I had to pay for the guy's sprinklers, $5,000.
Right.
But, now I'm getting paid cash a lot. I'm trying to figure out how can I hide that from the IRS.
Right. Okay. Okay.
No, not really. How would you hide it from the IRS? If you get paid cash, from a
customer. Probably still want to know about this on camera, though. No? Yes?
No, I would. You know, wait. Let me just say this to you. Real Housewives of New Jersey. That's what happened.
Teresa Cadiz.
Teresa Cadiz.
What happened?
Just got out of federal prison, and now her husband's there.
Well, they were on the first episode, the first season of Real Housewives.
Right.
They never talked about what Joe did for a living.
Okay.
He was in construction.
Okay.
They bought this big house. The movers come. I swear to God, when he took out a wad of cash to pay the guys, I looked at it and I go, the IRS will be knocking at their door. And here, all these years later, I knew. I was like, how stupid.
Yep. She
you?
Spent a year in jail.
No. If you get paid cash, nobody knows that you're paid cash.
So yes. Should declare income. I mean, it's not good to not have,
I show income, but sometimes you get paid cash from a customer who, I have no, there's no paperwork. That's it.
By the way, if there are any IRS agents listening, I am Carrie Caravas, the CPA, not Ellen Karras.
Jerry Callow, not Jerry Callow.
I'm just asking, how would you do it? Not like how would you, if it was you, how would you?
No, once in a while we get paid in cash. I declare everything.
Okay.
I'm way too paranoid. I declare, and I don't get piggy with the deductions.
I'm not talking about a lot of money. Right. Like, $20 for a lawn,
Right. Oh, well, then go buy yourself a cup of coffee and a muffin. See, that I'm sure you can spend.
Okay.
If George Soros can hide all his money, I'm sure we can hide $20 for you.
I shouldn't worry about $20.
Yeah, you should not. Yeah. But if it's,
No, sometimes, sometimes I get paid for doing a sprinkler system. I put them in, I install them and stuff like that.
Right.
It's a fairly
you should put
large amount of
you
cash.
Should do you have a company an LLC or it's something to protect yourself?
Joey's Lawn Care.
Joey's Lawn Care.
I'm sorry. I'll
ask a JLC.
I'm just thinking I should have the camera while you guys are talking.
He's got an LLC. He's got a JLC.
Okay, that's
Three Stone.
Joey's Lawn Care.
Bushwax.
Okay.
Side of the road.
Okay.
Actually, Petroni's Lawn Care, and then Joey's.
It's a
PLC. I'm the CEO. The owner.
Okay.
Operator.
All right. We'll talk off camera.
Okay.
Okay.
Great.
I was just saying.
I don't know
anybody who does paperwork. Everybody I know, nobody holds a pen. We're all construction.
Well, now it's spreadsheet.
Jungle Construction Company.
Oh my God. You have this very perplexed look on your face.
He's going to jail.
I didn't even collect money yet, so.
Yeah.
I love how serious Joe's dead ass right now. Dead ass. Like, you're serious right now. Like, yeah.
He wants advice. He wants tax advice.
This is good.
I had a question.
Claim it all.
I like
claim it.
You don't have to drag it out.
He's so funny. He's like, we should have him
and Mike
and
Fine,
and Mike Fine on the show together.
Oh my God!
Oh, I know Mike Fine.
Yeah,
yes.
God, I can't even keep together.
He's come on the show as a reverend. He's a reverend when he comes on the show.
A reverend or a reverend? A reverend?
Reverend.
Mike Fine? Jewish Mike Fine.
Yeah, with a priest collar. He's been on the show twice.
Uh-huh.
And he's a reverend, and he offers roadside assistance with marriages.
It's very advice. And tax advice. Probably tax advice.
He'll probably help you with tax advice.
For $8.95.
Yeah. The platinum package comes with that.
The platinum package, roadside assistance.
Divorce. All for
he gives
marriage.
A lot of advice.
Right.
And
right.
Or a divorce. He'll handle divorces mm-hmm. too.
Yeah, oh, okay. And that's all right. Whatever.
But are you girls married?
Oh, no.
You're not married? Nobody's married?
Who's married?
Raise your hand if you're married.
I'm married.
You're married.
He's married.
Everybody's married but me.
I'm married.
No, you're not married, right?
Well, the marriage part will probably be at the end of the next episode of the Gagoot Show.
The marriage part?
Yeah, we'll talk about marriage.
What?
Because I think we have to go soon.
We got two minutes warning.
1 minute.
Now we got 1 minute.
One minute warning.
It's the final countdown.
Who likes being married?
This show should be like football. We're going to take a timeout. We'll be right back.
Ten minutes. So, I guess we're not talking about marriage.
Well, who likes being married? Who likes being married?
I like
you enjoy
being
it?
Married.
I love being married.
I do.
Yes.
I enjoy it. Okay. My husband has health insurance, and I'm just
there. You go.
I'm set.
That's perfect. That's
it. I'm into wife swapping now, though.
Oh, that's
right. But not for another wife.
Right.
And one
we are.
Is that a TV show?
We could be. We're not. We can't be bothered with that. We're too tired. We can tolerate each other.
I don't want another wife. I want to swap Nancy for maybe a bicycle or
an item.
A BB gun. Yeah.
An item.
A slingshot.
Okay.
That's good. A slingshot. Jack in the Box.
I'm only kidding. I love you, honey. I love you.
Nancy,
you're the greatest thing
to
happen.
I love how he
swaps
her
for weapons. Nancy is one of the nicest ladies. Yes. You're a very lucky man.
Thank you very much.
She's a very nice woman, Nancy.
Yeah. And Joey does a lot of work with Nancy.
That's right.
He's very helpful.
She pays me cash, and I don't claim it.
Oh, here we go.
I don't know anything about this.
Good, now they'll get audited. Okay.
Yeah.
As long as it ain't us.
And I'll be in jail.
But all right.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, Nancy and Benny are like a great couple.
They are.
A lucky man.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's like Still and Mara. It's got that.
Yeah, yeah.
Although one of them passed, so maybe that's not a good example. But you know what I'm saying.
No, I'm glad you said that because I have described, and Nicole will tell you that we all like Still and Mara. We are.
Yeah.
Well, can I plug my website?
You go right ahead.
You can. EllenCaris.com, ELLENKARIS. I got a radio show, Mondays on BeboxRadio.com. You can find it on my website. I'm in Sisters, hot pink dress, and I got a lot of shows coming up, so check that out on my calendar.
Excellent.
Joey, where are you going to be? Give us your website.
Just keep an eye on I'm on Facebook, Petroni's Lawn Care. Petroni's Lawn Care. Cash only. Cash only. Petroni's Lawn Care.
That's awesome.
We'll talk later.
Okay.
This is a weird show, I gotta tell you.
I do snow removals, too.
You can find me on
LI News Radio
with the Hollywood Hit List. I'm Jeannie Powers on LI News Radio 103.9, Party 105.3, and Country 96.1 every Friday from 6 to 9 a.m. 6 to 9 a.m. Yes, I am on the Honda commercial. Friday afternoons from 4 to 6 p.m.
Sorry.
You can find me at www.nicolamonaco.com and follow me there on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. All my stuff is on there. So, Benny, anything else?
You could find me on Facebook where I'm trying to unload about a dozen of these jackets that I bought.
That's a very Mike Fine jacket, by the way. It is.
Oh, thank you very much.
Well, he's trying to camouflage himself into this.
We gotta wrap it up over here. I'm sorry to cut you guys short, but we're gonna say goodnight and thank you guys so much for coming.
Thank you for having me.
See you next Tuesday.
That we will. Have a good night. Take care.
Bye.
Some people live in the city. Some people live in the country. Others live in the mountains. Me? I live on an island. Long Island.